Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Oh, sorry. Father, we thank you this morning for another opportunity and privilege, Lord, to come together in your name and to worship you. God, you said where two or three would come together in your name, you'd be here in the midst. And God, we know you're here amongst us. And God, we ask that your will be accomplished in this service. God, I pray your anointing, God, will destroy every yoke of the enemy this morning. God, let your freedom and your liberty be amongst your people. God, let healing come forth, God, to those that need healing. God, let salvation come to those that need saved this morning. Father, we give you honor and we give you glory and we give you praise in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let's worship the Lord this morning.
Amen. Good morning, everyone. And if you're fairly new to the church, welcome. God bless you. Thank God for His mercies and His goodness and His grace for waking us up this morning and starting us on our way. Amen. Let's worship this morning, church, as we sing this opening song, Graves into Gardens.
I searched the world, but it couldn't fill me. A man's empty praise and treasures that fade are never enough. Then you came along and put me back together. And every desire is now satisfied here in your love. Oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you. There's nothing. Nothing is better than you. I'm not afraid to show you my weakness. My failures and flaws, Lord, you've seen them all, and you still call me friend. Because the God of the mountain is the God of the valley. There's not a place your mercy and grace won't find me again. Oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you. There's nothing. Nothing is better than you. Oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you. There's nothing. Nothing is better than you. You turn mourning to dancing. You give beauty for ashes. You turn shame into glory. You're the only one who can. You turn graves into gardens. You turn bones into armies. You turn seas into highways. You're the only one who can. You're the only one who can. Oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you. There's nothing. Nothing is better than you.
There's nothing
better than you. There's nothing better than you. There's nothing. Nothing is better than you.
Amen, amen. Oh, yes. Amen.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing His mercy and His grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, He'll prepare for us a place. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathway, clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a shadow on a side. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of Him in glory will the joys of life repay. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout victory. Before us, soon His beauties will behold. Soon the pearly gates will open. We shall tread the streets of gold. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout victory. Yes, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout victory. Oh, when we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout victory.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Have your way, Lord.
For behold, I am the Lord thy God, and I have gone.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Trust me and know that I am God, and surely I am coming soon, and my reward is with me. Turn thy face toward me, set thy feet upon me today, and I will surely deliver thee. I will take care of thee. I will provide for thee. I have gone to prepare a place for each and every one of you, and if I go to prepare a place for you, I will surely come again and receive you unto myself. Believe and trust and know that I am God and I am coming and I am coming soon.
Thank you, Lord.
And lift your hands this morning, church, and just worship the Lord for His word. Oh, yes. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. 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 Thank you, Jesus. God is real, church. He's real. God is real, He's real in my soul. My God is real, for He has washed and made me whole. His love for me is like pure gold. My God is real, for I can feel Him in my soul.
Just now it has.
Oh, yes. Jesus. My God is real, He's real in my soul. Yes, God is real, for He has washed and made me whole. His love for me is my pure gold. My God is real, for I can feel Him in my soul. My God is real, He's real in my soul. My God is real, for He has washed and made me for me is like pure gold. My God is real, for I can feel Him in my soul.
Amen. Do you believe He's real this morning? He's not asleep. He's not on the cross, but He's sitting at the right hand of the Father making intercession for you and I this morning. Amen. We don't serve some dead God, but we serve a living God this morning that still hears and answers prayer. If you have a need today, would you just slip up your hand toward Him? Raise it to Him. Amen. He already knows, but He said, ask and you shall receive. Knock and it shall be open. Amen. As we pray this morning, amen, pray in faith, believing that God is going to answer your need this morning, because He is real and He still hears and answers prayer. Amen. Let's pray today. Father, we thank You this morning, God, that You hold all power and authority today. And God, You are able, God, to heal all manner of sickness and disease today. And Father, we come before You asking, God, for Your help today. Understanding, God, we have limits. And God, we can only do so much. But today, we ask, God, for Your help. God, touch those that need healing this morning. God, touch those that need deliverance this morning. Touch those that need peace, Lord, in their hearts this morning. Touch those, God, that need saved this morning. Touch those that need set free, God, this morning. God, we pray today, God, You'd visit every person here in this building. Visit each and every one in the hospital today. Visit those that are watching this morning. And God, show them Your realness. Show them Your power. And God, hear and answer their prayer this morning. Father, we ask it all this morning by faith, believing, God, that You're able. God, we ask it all in the name of Jesus. And everyone said in agreement this morning, amen. Hallelujah.
God is real. He's real in my soul. My God is real, for He has washed and made me whole. His love for me is like pure gold. My God is real, for I can feel Him in my soul. His love for me is like pure gold. My God is real, for I can feel Him in my
soul. World of sin.
Been
washed in the blood of Jesus. I've been born again. Hallelujah, I'm saved, saved, saved by His wonderful grace. I'm so glad that I found out He could bring me out and show me the way. Thank God I am free, free, free from this world of sin. Washed in the blood of Jesus, I've been born again. Hallelujah, I'm saved, saved, saved by His wonderful grace. I'm so glad that I found out He could bring me out and show me the way.
For a long time I traveled
down a long lonely road. My heart was so heavy in sin I sank low.
Then I heard about Jesus.
Oh yes.
What a wonderful hour.
I'm so glad that I found out He could bring me out through His saving power. Thank God I am free, free, free from this world of sin. Washed in the blood of Jesus, I've been born again. Hallelujah, I'm saved, saved, saved by His wonderful grace. I'm so glad that I found out He could bring me out and show me the way. Like a bird out of prison that's taken its flight. Like the blind man that God gave back His sight. Like a poor wretched beggar that's found fortune and fame. I'm so glad that I found out He would bring me out through His holy name.
Sing it, church.
Oh, thank God I am free, free, free from this world of sin. Been washed in the blood of Jesus, I've been born again. Oh, hallelujah, I'm saved, saved, saved by His wonderful grace. I'm so glad that I found out He would bring me out and show me the way. Thank God I am free, free, free from this world of sin. Been washed in the blood of Jesus, I've been born again. Hallelujah, I'm saved, saved, saved by His wonderful grace. I'm so glad that I found out He would bring me out and show me the way. Oh, thank God I am free, free, free from this world of sin. I've been washed in the blood of Jesus, I've been born again. Hallelujah, saved, saved, saved by wonderful grace. I'm so glad that I found out He would bring me out and show me the way. I'm so glad that I found out He would bring me out and show me the way. Show me the way.
Come on, give Him a hand clap of praise. Are you glad you're free this morning? No longer entangled by that yoke of sin and bondage. Amen. We have been set free by the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Are you glad you're free this morning? I'm not who I used to be. Amen. I've been washed in the blood of Jesus. If you've been washed in the blood of Jesus, amen, you got a reason to rejoice today. Hallelujah. Can we sing it again this morning?
Amen. Oh, thank God I am free.
Let Him free you today.
Free from this world. Sin.
Oh, hallelujah.
I've been washed in the blood of Jesus. I've been born again. Hallelujah. Save, save, save by His wonderful grace. I'm so glad that I found out He would bring me out and show me the way.
Hallelujah.
Yes, thank God I am free, free, free from this world of sin. Been washed in the blood of Jesus, I've been born again. Hallelujah, I'm saved, saved, saved by His wonderful grace. I'm so glad that I found out He would bring me out and show me the way. I'm so glad that I found out He would bring me out and show me the way.
Show me the way.
Hallelujah. hand clap of praise. Are you glad you're free this morning? Amen. Aren't you glad today for the shed blood of Jesus Christ that we can walk in freedom from sin and condemnation? The devil likes to remind us who we used to be. Amen. But when you've been washed in the blood of Jesus, amen, those old things have passed away. And behold, all things have become new. I'm not a drunk no more. I'm not a stoner no more. I've been washed by the blood of Jesus. And I am free today. Are you glad for your freedom? Come on, give Him praise. He saw value in you that He gave His life. He bled and He died to redeem us. Amen. And we ought to rejoice. Hold your head up high and you tell the devil, I'm a blood-bought child of the Most High God. Amen. Praise God. Give Him one more hand and you can be seated today. Amen. You can be seated if you can be this morning. Hallelujah. Good to feel the Holy Ghost in this house this morning. Amen. I remember when I wasn't saved, when there would be a party, I'd go running telling everybody, come on over here. We're going to party. Amen. I'm excited this morning. Amen. I don't have to run to a party. I don't have to drink out of a keg. Amen. But I'm drinking from the living water this morning. And I found freedom in Jesus. And I'm happy and excited about it this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. People are searching this morning. Amen. And we're drinking from that fountain today. Amen. And it's free this morning. Luke chapter 9, verses 28 through 29. Luke chapter 9, verses 28 through 29. God is real today. I mean, He knows He's real at church and He's real at home. He's real wherever we go. Luke chapter 9, verses 28 and verses 29. If you found that, say amen. If you don't have your Bibles, it's on the screen there for you. It says, it came to pass about on the 8 days after these sayings, He took Peter, John, and James, and they went up into the mountain to pray. And as He prayed, the fashion of His countenance was altered, and His raiment was white and glistening. This morning I want to preach on the thought, if we will go to the mountain, we can see things altered. If we will go to the mountain, we can see things altered. Let's pray. Father, I thank You, Lord, for the freedom of knowing that my sins have been forgiven. Thank You, God, for Your presence, God, that's been felt already here in this house. God, I want You to know, God, that You are welcome in this place. And Father, I pray this morning, God, as I deliver Your word this morning, help me to say, God, what You once said to Your people. God, this is not my word, this is Your word. And God, I pray everything that I say, God, that I would say it under the unction and the anointing of the Holy Ghost. God, anoint every ear to hear and every heart to receive. Father, I pray it all in the name of Jesus. And everyone said again, amen. The word altered, according to the dictionary, it means to change, to become different, or to be modified. And I believe this morning, if you and I will learn to go to the mountain, we can see things begin to change. We can see things to become different. And we can see things to become modified. Amen. But it's about making an effort and going to the mountain. Amen. When you and I pray, we should begin to see things, amen, to become different. Because I believe this morning prayer still changes things. Amen. We see here in the scripture that Jesus takes Peter and John and James up to the mountain to pray. Amen. We know Jesus loved His disciples and He wanted them to see the importance of going to the mountain to pray. Amen. So many times we focus on the miracles and the mighty works that Jesus done as He walked this earth. And I thank God this morning that we can look into His Word and find that He healed the deaf. He opened the eyes of the blind. Amen. He reached down and lifted up crippled people. And He done mighty, mighty miracles when He walked upon this earth. Amen. But we must also understand there are things that Jesus did while He was on this earth. Amen. To show us the importance of things that He did. Amen. Not only healing the sick. Amen. Opening the eyes of the blind. But we can find many, many times that Jesus got alone and He prayed. Amen. The Bible says they went up to a mountain to pray. Amen. And when they were there, that Jesus showed them His glory. They saw, amen, His glorified body. Amen. They saw the glory of God upon Jesus as they were there at the mountain. Amen. I want us all to understand the importance of going to the mountain to pray. The Bible says they went up to a mountain to pray. They didn't go to the temple to pray. They didn't go in the midst of the crowd to pray. They didn't go in the midst of the city to pray. Amen. But the Bible says they went up to a mountain. Amen. A place away from everything that was going on. A place of sacrifice. Amen. Because I'm sure it would have been easier just to go to the temple and pray. It would have been easier probably just to stay at home and pray, but they made a sacrifice and they went up to a mountain. Amen. They didn't have an elevator or one of those lifts to get them up the mountain. They had to walk and make an effort, amen, to get up to the mountain and get alone, amen, away from everything that was going on. Amen. Because we know that when Jesus came to town, amen, that multitudes would come. Amen. People would flock Him and they would try to get near Him. Amen. But He got away from all that and He went up into the mountain. The Son of God, amen, our perfect example. Amen. There were many times that He had to get alone and He had to pray. Amen. You want your prayers to make things different in your life? Then you need to find a mountain and go and pray. Amen. Some people think they got to pray King James to get their prayers answered. Amen. Some people think they got to go to the pastor, amen, to get their prayer answered. Some people think the only time God answers prayer is in God's house. Amen. But I believe this morning God still hears and answers prayer. Amen. When we make an effort to go to the mountain. Amen. When we make an effort to find a place, amen, to get alone, amen, and pour out our hearts before God's. Amen. It's not about the words we say. It's about getting along with God and sharing our hearts and pouring our hearts out to Him. Amen. Some people think you got to kneel. Some people think you got to sit. Some people say you got to face the east. Some people say you got to do this and you got to do that. I don't believe it's the position of the body. It's the condition of our heart. Amen. Your steering wheel could be your mountain. Sister Poole said she used to go in the bathroom and kneel by her bathtub. Amen. Your bathtub may be your mountain. Amen. But wherever it is, you need to find a place, amen, to get alone and get a hold of God and let God show you His glory and His power and let God show you that He can make a difference in your prayer life. So I believe when we pray, we can see things altered or we can see things to become different. We can see things to change. Amen. But we got to make an effort to find a mountain, a place alone, away from everything else. Amen. We all may have a different place, but we need to find a place. Amen. Just where it's you and God. Amen. When we go to the mountain, there are times we need to ask God to change us. Acts chapter 6, verse 15. It says, "And all that sat in the council, looking steadfastly on Him, saw His face as it had been the face of an angel. We know this is talking about Stephen. Amen. Stephen was just an ordinary man like you and I. Amen. But the Bible says that when they looked upon his face, amen, that his face shined like an angel. Amen. We know when Jesus prayed, the Bible says his countenance was changed. Amen. And they saw him in his glory. Amen. When he got up to the mountain and he began to pray, amen, that his countenance, the Son of God, his countenance was changed. We know that Stephen's face shined like the face of an angel. And we can look back in the Old Testament when Moses went up into the place. Amen. And he was there and God gave him the Ten Commandments. I believe that's when it was. But when he came back down from the mountain, amen, the Bible says that the glory of God was so great upon him that they had to put a veil on his face. Amen. They couldn't look at him because he had so much of the glory and the power of God manifesting itself out of him. Amen. And I believe a lot of times, amen, when we go to the mountain, we need to pray, God, change me. God, help me to change. God, let people see me and let them see you. We shouldn't have to wear a Christian t-shirt, amen, to let everybody know we're saved, born again, and going to heaven. People ought to look at you and say, man, there's something different about her. There's something different about him. Why? Because they've been to the mountain and they've been in the presence of God and their countenance has been altered. Amen. The appearance about them has been changed. Amen. We need to go to the mountain and say, God, change me. Help me, God, to let my light shine. Let me portray you on the outside. Amen. We sing a song, Jesus on the inside. Amen. Working on the outside. So many times we're praying, God, change everybody else. Amen. What about God, change me? Help me, God. Let me change. Let me be more like you. Amen. I told you a story. I told you this before about a man in Wheatfield. His name was Cliff Kearns. He's gone on to be with the Lord. Brother Cliff would greet you when you come into the church, and Brother Cliff had a glow about him. He had a smile on his face. Every time you saw him, you saw, amen, just a glow about him. Amen. I believe the reason he had a glow like he had, it wasn't he was some rich man that had everything the world had to give him. Amen. But Brother Cliff knew the importance of going to the mountain. Amen. And getting alone with God. Amen. Brother Cliff experienced God throughout the week. So when Sunday came and you walked into the church, the first thing you saw, amen, was the smile of Brother Cliff Kearns. Amen. What do people see when they look at you? Do they see the glory of God manifesting out of your life, or do they see some mad, angry, upset individual? We sing that song, I'm so glad Jesus set me free, but so many Christians look like they're so mad Jesus set them free. Huh? We need to allow God to manifest Himself in us. We need to allow the glory of God to shine forth out of our lives that people can approach us. Some people are afraid to approach Christians because their tongues are so long and they'll snatch them up and tell them how bad they are. Lord, don't let the glory shine to give me glory. That people will look at me, but that people will see the love of God that I have and it's spilling over and they want some of what you got. Amen. Not because you're mad. Like I said last week, Jesus came to save the world, not to condemn the world. They've heard enough condemnation. We've all heard enough condemnation. We need to experience the love of God. But if we don't go to the mountain and we don't get alone with God, we don't have no love flowing in our lives. God, change me. Help the love of God shine. Then the Bible says the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost. Amen. You got the Holy Ghost inside you. You ought to have the love of God flowing in your life. But we got to make an effort to go to the mountain. And when we get to the mountain, say, God, change me. Amen. God, help me to see this situation different. Amen. Sister I always use Sister Poole, but she was talking about, I remember we used to sit in her class, there was ladies, I think, that she worked with that cussed all the time, and she said, just pray, Lord, shut their mouth. And God shut their mouth. Amen. We ought to pray, not, Lord, just shut their mouth, but Lord, let me shine forth that others could see you shining forth out of me. Amen. All right, let's go on. You need a situation altered in your life. You need a situation changed in your life. Amen. Don't always expect somebody else to pray for you. There are times we got to get alone ourselves and ask God, amen, to change our situation. Amen. James 5:16, you ought to all know this by now. It says, confess your faults one to another, pray for one another, that you may be healed. But it also says, the effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Amen. You don't need me to lay my hands on you. You don't need people to gather around you. There are times I believe we need those things, but we must first go to the mountain on our own, and we must seek God for ourselves. And if we don't find an answer there, then you come and you call for the elders to gather around you. I believe there's times we need laid hand on and prayed for. Amen. I'm not trying to tell you don't come up here and I don't want to pray for nobody, because I believe in that. But I believe also, amen, when you don't have no hands to lay on you and you don't have nobody you can call, amen, you can find a way to the mountain and you can get a hold of God all by yourself. Bible says the effectual, fervent prayer. Amen. We need to just more than just, Lord, I need a healing. Lord, I just need a miracle. We need to bombard heaven and we need a fervent prayer before God. Amen. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord. But don't go to the mountain and waste your time if you don't believe God can do what you're asking Him to do. Don't even climb the mountain. Don't even attempt to approach God if you don't even think God can do what you're about to ask Him to do. Amen? Remember, Jesus did not many mighty works in towns and cities when He was walking this earth. Why didn't He do the miracles? Because of unbelief. Amen? It stopped Him from doing what He desired to do. Don't go to the mountain and pray if you don't believe God can do what you're about to ask Him to do. Amen. But when you get up and you say, I'm going to go to the mountain and I'm going to pray before God, have faith and believe that God can do what you need Him to do. God is still a supernatural God that can do supernatural things, but we got to go to the mountain to get them. And we got to fervently pray before God. Amen. We don't like to fervently pray no more. We like to microwave prayers or drive-through prayers. Whew. Lord, here I am. I'm going to go get this, this, and that. I need this, that, and the other. And then I'm gone. Big Mac, quarter pounder, cheese, large fry. Amen. I'll see you later. How many knows we need to stop what we're doing? Amen. There are people dying and going to hell around us. There are people that need miracles in this church. Amen. You need God to change the situation in your life. Stop what you're doing. Find the mountain and get a hold of God. Amen. Amen. Let God alter your situation. Let God begin to change things for you. Amen. You need a stronghold broken. You need a stronghold altered in your life. You got to find a mountain. Amen. Maybe you're here today. You have some strongholds in your life. Things that Satan has put upon your life. Hey man, they just don't seem like they're going to let go. You got some strongholds in your life. Hey man, you got an attitude that you just can't get rid of. Maybe it's a habit. Maybe it's something in your life that Satan has placed and it's a stronghold. Hey man, I like what 2 Corinthians 10:4 says. It says, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Amen. You need a stronghold broken in your life. Go to the mountain. Amen. Get along with God and let God break your strongholds. Amen. There's still power in prayer. You believe it or not? There's still power in prayer. Strongholds can be broken today. Amen? But we got to make an effort to find a mountain. We got to get along with God and ask God to break those strongholds. Amen? Find a mountain. Let God break those strongholds. The weapons of our warfare are not carnal. What are our weapons? We have the power. Amen. We can use prayer and we can use the Word of God. Amen. And those strongholds can and will be broken in our lives. We're not effective for God if we got a bunch of strongholds in our life, are we? Satan wants to latch them on us, but we don't want to go to the mountain to get rid of them. God wants to break those strongholds. If we'll make an effort to find a mountain. You need delivered from something, go to the mountain. Amen. Luke 4:18, it says, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because He hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and the recovering of the sight to the blind, and to set to them, amen, set at liberty them that are bruised." Amen. You need God to deliver you from something today. Amen. Find a mountain. You need God to set you free from something this morning. Find a mountain. Amen. You need God, amen, to break those chains in your life. Amen. Maybe it's an addiction. Maybe it's an attitude. Maybe it's your eyes looking the wrong way. And you need God to break those things in your life. Amen. God will break those things that we need delivered from if we will make an effort to go to the mountain and find a place alone with God and allow God to break and bruise the head of the enemy this morning. The Bible says, "Greater is He that is in me than he that is in the world." The God in you is greater than the enemy that tries to bind you and to hold you down. Amen. You need delivered from something, you go to the mountain, find deliverance today. Amen. You tired of living an up and down, in and out Christian life? Amen. You try to struggle every day just to stay safe. I believe we need to get our heart fixed on God. Psalms 57 verse 7 says, "My heart is fixed, O God. My heart is fixed. I will sing and give praise." Are you tired of living an up and down relationship with the Lord? Are you tired of feeling like giving up every time a situation happens in your life? Are you tired of not having a desire for God anymore, His Word? Amen. I believe this morning you got to get your heart fixed on God. Amen. You got to get it settled down in your mind that God is number one in my life. I have to get my heart fixed on God. Amen. I can't fix my wife's heart on God. I couldn't fix my kids' my children's heart on God. It had to come to a place. They had to make a decision and a choice. They were going to get their hearts fixed on God. Amen. But if you want to walk with God and have a strong relationship with God, you got to get your heart fixed on Him. He has to be more important than your job. He has to be more important than your family. He has to be more important than everything that you own on this earth. Amen. You have to make sure that God is number one above everything else. You got to get your heart fixed on God, and then you got to find a mountain. Amen. Then you got to go to the mountain and say, "God, I'm tired of struggling. I'm tired of this difficulty. I'm tired of fighting this same thing over and over and over again. God, I got my heart fixed on You. Now I'm going to find me a mountain." Amen. You got your foot on the rock and you got your mind made up this morning. You say amen, hallelujah, praise God today. Well, what about tomorrow? When Satan comes and tries to do this or do that, are you strong enough to stand, amen, outside of church? See, it's easy to praise God in here. It's easy to worship God in here, but what about Tuesday? When you're having a bad day at work and everything seems to be falling apart, can you find a mountain by yourself? Can you learn to praise God anyhow? Amen. How come? So many times we think God changes just because our situations change. God never changes. Huh? Just because something bad's happened doesn't mean God's bad and God's changed. Yeah, we got to live life, and bad things do happen to good people, but God is still good in the midst of the bad things that are happening in our lives. Amen. You need God to alter your finances. Amen. Remember Malachi 3:10, bring ye all the tithes in the storehouse. There may be meat in mine house. Prove me now herewith, saith the Lord of hosts. It will not open up the windows of heaven, pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough. Amen. To receive it. You need God to alter your finances this morning. Amen. Don't forget to bring your tithes into the storehouse. Amen. When you bring your tithes into the storehouse, you can prove God. You can prove Him. Amen. I can stand up here and tell you time and time again, amen, that God has come through. Amen, because I have always learned, amen, to put God first. You need God to modify, change, and do something in your finances. Take your checkbook, take your bills, find an altar, lay them on the altar, and ask God to change some things. But don't you dare do that if you forgot to give God His first. And I'm not here to take an offering this morning, and I'm not here to get in your business. I'm here to help you. You want to see God do something different in your finances? Learn to put Him first. Amen. You need God to alter your finances. He's still able to do it today. You need God to alter your diagnosis. Go to the mountain. Go to the mountain. Matthew 10:1. And when He called unto Him His 12 disciples, He gave them power against unclean spirits to cast out and to heal all manner of sickness and all manner of disease. You believe that this morning? Maybe you're here today and you need a diagnosis changed. Find a mountain. Find a mountain. Find a mountain. Get alone with God. Amen. He can still all heal all manner of sickness and disease this morning. Amen. Let's stand to our feet today. God can still heal. God can still set free. God can still do what God's always done. Amen. If we'll find a mountain and we'll go to the mountain, amen, get alone with God. As we bow our heads and close our eyes this morning, I don't know what you're going through today. I don't know what you're experiencing in your life today. But I know God is no respecter of people. And I know this morning that if you will make an effort to find an altar, find a place alone with God, amen, God will begin to alter your situation. Maybe you're here this morning, you're not where you need to be with God. Maybe you're standing, walking at a distance from God. Maybe you once had a relationship with God, but something happened and your life has changed and you no longer walk with God. Can I tell you today, you're never going to be satisfied. You're never going to be complete on the inside. But if you'll make a way to this altar and say, Lord, I need You, God will come down and meet you, and God will begin to change your life, and He'll bring peace to your heart today. If that's you today, the altar's open. Would you come? You need God to change your heart. You need God to change your life. Or maybe you're here today. You got some situations you need to change. The altars are open. Will you make a trip up the mountain this morning out of your seat, making an effort to the altar and say, God, I need You to change a situation in my life. I'm tired of fighting this thing. I'm tired of struggling with the same thing over and over again. I'm going to make a trip to the altar. I'm going to get alone with God here at the altar this morning. If that's you today, would you come? You need God to make some changes in your life. Come, the altars are open. Now I want to ask one more thing. There are many people we know today that need their diagnosis changed, altered. They need God to move. Would you be willing to get out of your seat, come up here, and come to the mountain and stand in the gap and make up the hedge for them that need a healing, that need a miracle today? Would you come? Somebody, come stand in the gap, make up the hedge. The altars are open. Say, I'm going to go to the mountain for my brother or my sister that needs God to alter their diagnosis. Come, the altars are open. Find you a place. Amen. Kneel around the altar. Yes. Stand in the gap. Make up the hedge at the altar. Hallelujah. If you don't want to come up front, let's all find us a place of prayer. Pray for those that need healing. If you have nothing else to pray for, pray for those that need a miracle this morning. If you need a miracle in your life, God is here. Thank you, Jesus.
Situations, that tug of war at me, all day long I struggle for the answers that I need. Then I come into His presence, all my questions become clear, and for a sacred moment, no doubt can interfere. Presence of Jehovah, God Almighty.
Can you stretch your hands this way?
To find the answers in the hours of distress, there is never any reason to give up in despair. Just slip away and breathe His name. He will come and meet you there in the presence of Jehovah.
Can we stand and sing it this morning? For surely we're in the presence
God
of the Most High God.
Almighty,
hallelujah.
Prince of Peace. Troubles vanish. Broken hearts are mended. In the presence. God Almighty, sweet Prince of Peace, troubles vanish and hearts are mended in the sing it one more time. In the presence, in the presence of Jehovah, God Almighty, you're the Prince of Peace. Troubles vanish and broken hearts are mended in the presence of the King.
I want us to sing it again this morning. I want you to close your eyes. I want you to forget about what you're going through. I want you to forget about the problem that stands in front of you. And I want you to look up toward heaven. And I want you to look and see how big your God is. And look and see what He is able to do on your behalf today. Amen. We focus so much on our problems and our situations that we forget we're in the presence of the Creator of the universe. We forget we're in the presence of the One that can speak a word and cancer can fall off right here this morning. Let's sing it again today. Hallelujah.
In the presence of Jehovah, God Almighty, you're the Prince of Peace. Troubles vanish, broken hearts are mended in the presence of the King. Oh, in the presence of Jehovah, God Almighty, sweet Prince of Peace, troubles vanish and hearts are mended in the presence of the King.
Hallelujah. I want you to lift your hands toward heaven. Begin to thank God for what He's doing. Begin to thank God for answering your prayer. Thank God for the healing of cancer this morning. Thank God for the miracles He's going to do in our behalf this morning. Thank God for the strongholds that are being broken this morning. Thank God for the salvations that are going to come forth. Thank God for the healings that are going to come forth. Thank God for the miracles that are going to come forth. Thank God this morning for what He's doing here in our midst. Oh, hallelujah. God, we honor you today. Come on, hallelujah, give me praise. Hallelujah, give me praise. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you this morning. Hallelujah. Go ahead, sing it, brother. Thank you, Jesus.
God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He works in ways we cannot see.
You believe that?
He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to His side. With love and strength for each new day, He will make a way. He will make a way. God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for me, and He will be my guide.
Yes, Lord.
Hold me closely to His side, with love and strength for each new day. He will make a way. He will make a way.
Do you believe that this morning? Amen. Raise your hands if you believe it this morning. Give Him a hand of praise. Hallelujah. I believe He's already made a way this morning. I believe He's already started something this morning. Amen. I believe we're going to hear some testimonies this morning of what God has done. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Make sure you find time to go to the mountain this afternoon, will you? Pray for service tonight. Service tonight, 6 o'clock. Amen. Sister Darla, will you dismiss us today in prayer?